topic is, does sexual assault victims get justice? And for my presentation, my claim is sexual assault victims do not get proper justice in this country, I personally think. And in the following slides, I'm going to show you why I think that they don't get proper justice. These are the contents. We're going to be talking about what is sexual assault, few facts about the sexual assault rate in Bangladesh, the statistics, what happens to the harassment cases in Bangladesh, the evidences that these are happening every day, every second, every hour, and the reasons why these are happening, and at the end we're going to talk about the conclusion. So what is sexual assault? The term sexual assault refers to sexual contact or behavior that occurs without explicit consent of the victim. So it can be for any sort of relationship. You need to have consent with your friend, girlfriend, even in marriage, there should be consent. Nothing can be done without permission. This is one of the known facts that according to Bangladesh Mohila Coalition, a total of 3,495 women and girls face violence, including sexual harassment, attempted rape, murder, and suicide. After rape in 2022, the number itself is a very big number because within a year, imagine almost 3,500 people being raped or harassed and then ending up killing themselves just because of this reason. That means how the law is working, how poorly everything is being controlled, that they are not making proper justice. That's why this is happening. These are the statistics. This is still only 2021. As we've seen in our previous slide, the number in 2022, in 2021, a total of 1,000 rape cases occurred, which increased in a span of 1 year, and it increased in a span of 1 year to 3,495. And this statistic has been made by the ASK, I know Shafinaz Kendra and Odhikar Foundation. This is a formally conducted survey and it's as accurate as possible. So what actually happens to the sexual harassment cases in Bangladesh? From January to June 2022, only 39 cases were reported out of 728 women. 304 of them were adults and 424 underage girls. Which means only 39 got justice or their cases were filed, rest were dismissed. The reasons why these are happening is ineffective judiciary governance body. So first of all, the law, it isn't properly set. That's why these people get the encouragement, because they know they won't get proper punishment for it. They can bail themselves out once they commit a crime. That's why they can still commit such crime even in this generation, even in this year, even though when we are way ahead in every other sectors except for the law sector. For the patriarchal society, women are tended to put, like, they're kind of put down in the society. Women should be at home, they shouldn't work outside, they shouldn't wear these clothes, they shouldn't be outside more than after 7. These mentalities what causes such things. People think we, like the guys, they think they're dominant, they have the right to oppress a woman. Rampant drug abuse. We all know how drugs are being sold without any restrictions. Even though we have police or RAB over here, still drugs are being sold, and the power of the drug is being abused. With the influence of the drugs, such crimes are being committed, and objectification of women's body. We all know how women's are objectified in their day-to-day life in Bangladesh. Teeth teasing is a very normal thing in Bangladesh. Every woman suffers from it every day, at least 4 to 5 times. And in conclusion, since Bangladesh is developing in every area, but in terms of law, they are slightly backdated. They still follow the laws which were followed back in the 90s. So those no longer apply anymore, since all of them are modern. Everything is updated. Same goes for the people. These don't apply anymore. And if they can upgrade their law, if they can tighten their security or make strict laws and rules, that if you commit such crimes, you're going to face such consequences, then we can possibly avoid such future possible sexual assault cases and decrease the number of these cases, and hopefully provide a safer environment for everyone in the future. That's all for the presentation. Thank you.
So, it's feedback to Shabai.
Proper justice.